Hi there, I'm Nathan Carver with Zimco Instrumentation. I'm here with you guys today to talk about our ER5000 electro pneumatic transducer from Tescom. So what this device does is basically takes a mechanical regulator and makes it into a smart data logging device. The mechanical regulator can be either pressure reducing or back pressure, so both the applications are covered in that regard. Anyhow, the way this device works, simple enough, is with a plumb a pressure transducer in downstream or upstream, depending on your application, and when there's a system upset, something happens, and there's a change in the control pressure or set point, this will automatically bring that regulator back to where it needs to be. So it'll take it from, if there's a 1 PSI or a 2 PSI variation, you can't have that, it's a critical system, it immediately takes it back. It actuates at 1/100 of a second, so it's pretty darn fast. Today I'm gonna go over a few of the applications where we've seen this, people make use of this device. I actually have this is a working demo, and I will be running you through a few different profiles which talk about, they'll be demoing basically a system upset in the field or in a lab or whatever the case may be. And you'll have these things happen, and this will react automatically to the system upset based on how we program it. But I guess enough with all that, I should probably jump in and show you guys what this thing looks like in action. So if you like, come with me and we'll take a look at this thing running in three separate system upset applications. All right, so here we are in the interface of our ER-Tune software, as you can see. I'm sure you can all see it on the screen here. So what I've got here is our basic interface showing our PID controls, which just allows you to change your proportional, derivative, and integral modes to give you a bit better, tighter tuning on certain things like changing your set points, like keeping certain pressure active for a certain amount of time. So what I've done here is I just basically set the defaults. It does come with its own set of defaults, and they're pretty tight as it is. So we have about maybe a second and a half when we do pressure changes on the system here. So anyways, what I'm gonna do here, I'll jump right through it. I'm gonna go to the profile tab in our ER-Tune software, and I have in here a few profiles that I've kind of made up for the purposes of this video. So we're gonna jump into this here with our test profile number one, which I've called overpressure. And an overpressure scenario, as maybe some of you may know, is when you have a regulator set at a certain set point, in this case we're calling it 10%, and you need it to stay there, because if it goes above, in any manner of speaking, let's say it goes up to 26% of its range, you're gonna have a PSV go on your line or something like that's gonna happen. It won't be any good for anybody, because you have to send a guy out to get it reset, changed. So anyways, what I'm gonna do here, I'll show you what it looks like, and we're gonna go ahead and operate this thing at 10% of its range. That's gonna be our set point. The situation will change and we'll get up to about 25% of our range. Let's call it a temperature change or a system fluctuation where there's a spike of pressure from a pump or whatever the case may be, but we're gonna just call it what we will. We're gonna show you how fast this thing takes it right back down to its desired 10% set point. And we'll go from there. So the way you do this is once you have a profile loaded in, your profile builder is pretty standard run-of-the-mill stuff. It's all very user-friendly. Built these ones in advance to make the video a little shorter anyways, but we'll take a look at it. So once your profile's set up, you click the download button here, and we'll go ahead and click the OK. So now we've downloaded this profile to the ER5000. We're gonna go down to the tuning tab once again, and we're gonna go ahead and start our profile. So I like to, my plot's already been going here, as you can see. I like to start the profile at about 0 seconds, just so we can kind of keep that, you know, that natural visual of whatever's happening here. And as you'll see, we've got to our 10% set point, and temperatures change. We have a bit of a system upset and brings it right back down before it can even talk. Then we jump up to the next one here. So we're going right in. This pressure set point is gonna be a little bit slower. I think it takes about 5 seconds to get to its overpressure. But remember, we can't allow this. There we are. As you can see, we've got mere seconds, if that, to get right back to the set point desired, and then can keep it there for the whole night or basically whatever you set your profile to. So that's our first test anyways here, to show you kind of an overpressure scenario in a situation where you don't want a PSV to go downstream and you have to send a guy out. But That'll be the start. I'm gonna go back now to profile, and we're gonna open another profile. Put in three, like I stated. The next one's gonna be our test profile two. This is, I've called it precise set points. So some systems will have, in let's say a manufacturing facility or whatever the case may be, they'll have a system that you need to have a certain amount of pressure for a certain amount of time, otherwise you need no pressure at all. So what I've done here is I've set up a profile that kind of mimics a fill of paint cans or mold injected into a TV or something along those lines. It allows us to stay at our, you know, we jump up to the pressure we need to be, we're there for the time we need to be there, and then we step it right back down to zero and have nothing happen throughout. So what we do again, we're gonna go ahead and download that profile into the ER. Once it's in there, we're gonna go ahead and click OK. Jump back over to tuning as we are in the tuning tab. And once this loop here gets back to zero, we're gonna go ahead and start it. See it finished filling the one unit. Right back up to the next. Next unit's just about full, so we'll turn off the system and keep it back down to zero like it should be. And you'll see all the different steps showing up here in the current segment. It'll kind of tell you what step it's at. And yeah, just gives you kind of an idea of what it looks like and how fast this thing can actuate. So it's quite an impressive device for just regulating pressure or fluids or the case may be. So now we're gonna go back to the profile tab, as you can see here. We're going to open our third test profile, and this one I've called hysteresis. And what hysteresis is basically the action that happens when you have a mechanical regulator that you change the pressure set point. So let's call it, you know, we have a regulator that's set to 25 psi, we now need to change that to 50 psi, and we need it to go there instantaneously, right? So what we need to do in that case is on a mechanical regulator, as soon as we change that thing to 50 psi, very often it'll fluctuate before it actually gets there. It won't be at your 50 psi immediately. It'll take a minute to get there or whatever the case may be. Sometimes again, when you're bringing your pressure from 50 psi down to 15 psi, you could have that same sort of reaction. And we call that hysteresis. It's basically a slow moving change in a mechanical regulator. And there's the only way to really completely solve hysteresis is with a dome load regulator, which has a 1-to-1 ratio, which gives us basically an instant reaction. But this way here, using our ER5000, it allows us to really, really tighten up those pressure changes and just gives us kind of an idea of what you can see from something like this, where you have a system that's very sensitive to things like hysteresis. So we go ahead and we download that profile once again to our ER5000, and we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna jump back into the tuning profile. Let's run that profile. So again, wait till it gets to about zero on our time. Let's go ahead and start it again. So we're at our first set point. Sit there for as long as it needs. Go to our second set point. So again, you see how fast it'll get there and stay there. Drop right back down to our next set point. Once again, we're right where we need to be and solidly there. And then we're gonna jump right back up again to another set point. Case right there. So that kind of shows you three ways this thing can be operated in. And like I say, the opportunity for this to be used in your system is fairly endless. But any of these profiles, you can build your own, you can design your own, they can go on for hours and hours and hours. Like I say, for the purpose of this little video, I wanted to make them as short as I could. But yeah, that's all I got for the moment. Thank you very much. Welcome back. We're done with those little demos now, so I'm going to go into some frequently asked questions that come up on a regular basis from our clients. So over the years, people have asked hundreds of different questions, but I've chosen three here that I think are fairly viable in this situation. So the first question that comes to mind is somebody comes back and says, Nathan, what sort of equipment do I need to run this device? Do I need to add any extra instrumentation, or what do I need? I tell them it's fairly simple. The first thing you need is just a 24 volt power supply, so just to plug into the wall, as long as you're giving 24 volts to it, has the power it needs to run. And secondly, you also need a pneumatic supply pressure. So that pneumatic supply pressure needs to be clean, dry, inert gas, and needs to come in at about 80 to 110 PSI to keep it within that range, and this thing will operate just fine. That's it for that. And the second question I have here is from, it's basically asking me what communication protocols come with this. What does it typically use? And the first communication protocol is going to be obvious when you open the box. It's got a USB cable in there that you just plug right in, and it'll go into your PC or your laptop, whatever the case may be. But also for use with a PLC and other equipment, it uses the RS-485 communication protocol, and also can use external analog, so 4 to 20 milliamp, and of course 1 to 5 VDC. And yeah, I should answer that there for you. And one question that comes up very frequently once people see this thing in action is, how do I get that nifty software? Is it going to cost me? Is it? How do I get access to it? And I like the answer to that one. It's a beautiful answer. That software is entirely free. It's available on Emerson's website, right through their Tescom ER5000. And instead of jumping through hoops on their website, we've actually linked that in the comments below, so you can have access to that very easily. And you could even download it today. Just get familiar with it as it needs to be. Get used to using it, set a few profiles up, and then when the device arrives, you can plug it in and go from there. So it's a pretty excellent device, and the software is very, very user-friendly for most areas, labs, you know, in the field, wherever you are. So it's a great, great option. Anyways, that's about the gist there. I've got the three questions, and if there's any more questions or you have any more concerns about the device or just want to talk more about it with us, you can call us at 403-253-8320, or alternatively, you can email me directly, as I'm kind of the go-to Tescom guy here, as it turns out, and email me directly. I think we're going to set the email into the description below the video here. And with that, thanks a lot for watching and staying with us through the whole deal. And leave us a like and subscribe, and we'll get some more content on the way for you. Thank you.